modifying the squish is probably one of the easiest ways to improve the performance of your bike. Most people assume it's correct from the factory, and it usually is not, for various reasons. The squish ratio and the squish volume. The squish ratio is the percent of the bore area that the squish band occupies. The squish velocity is the speed of the squish air fuel in meters per second. As the piston rises, it squeezes that air into the main dome of the head. And the squish volume is the cubic centimeters between the squish band and the piston, all the way around. I know people have given a lot of thought and have experience with these two, but this has almost never been mentioned. And that's what this video is at least partly about, bringing your attention to the squish volume. Of course, as that band becomes wider, the volume increases. And on a previous video, I talked about the importance of that band and that volume being for increasing the length of the burn for more grunty power from the engine. Typically on heads, the wider the band, the more mid-range is being emphasized, and the narrower the band, the more the top end is being emphasized. In this example right here, the bore diameter is 69 millimeters. The inner dome diameter is 53, and the squish band width is 8. That gives a 41% ratio of squish area to total area, and a 23% ratio of those two widths divided by the bore diameter. With these three examples, we've got no squish band, which is typical for a lot of low RPM street bikes. The narrow squish band, you can see the lack of width right here. And a normal squish band is right here. This is a squish ratio of 26%, and this is a squish ratio of 40%. Because it's narrow, to get the same amount of velocity, you need a smaller clearance right here between the piston and the head. You need a less clearance than you would with a normal squish band. As I said before, when it squeezes that air and fuel out from that space there, it goes in and it runs into the opposing flow, and it causes it to go up and then swirl around. So that's what I call the swirl. And what I'm calling the swirl effect is how effective that squish is at creating that swirl. If you look at this graph right here, you can see the highest squish velocity is between 5 and 15 degrees. So if we analyze this setup at 20% squish ratio versus this setup at 40% squish ratio, using my squish calculator, I found that I need to have a 0.6 millimeter clearance on this one and a 0.95 millimeter clearance on this one. And the result of that is the volume that's squished from 5 to 15 degrees is 6.6% of the total TDC volume on this example, and it's 9.9% on this example. I've got a head that I was trying to get to work on my bike, and I finally just gave up because I didn't want to have a high compression ratio. And just looking at it, I'm like, what's going on through my head right now? I've got this really queasiness about me. I said, well, what is it? What is it? What is it? Let's think. And what I figured out is that I was doubting the ability of such a small band to have an effective amount of flow to create that swirl. So what I did on my calculator is I added a fifth calculation, which is the swirl effect. And what I did is I took the ratio of the calculated velocity to the recommended velocity and multiplied that by the amount of volume under the squish band that is displaced, that is squished from 15 degrees to 5 degrees. So it'd be this number right here minus this number right here. And then divided it by, when this is negative, that means that it's not as effective as you might think it would be, which means you would probably have to increase, which is basically saying when you have a small band, you have to have more squish velocity to make up for the lack of the volume, which makes the volume even worse. So it's like, you know, do it right, or just, you know, you just pull your hair out trying to get it to work right. A well-designed squish band is needed. So you can see in this case, the squish velocity is good. The volume is lacking. The ratio is lacking. Of course, those two go together. And because the clearance had to be made small to get that velocity where close to the recommended value, it increased the detonation risk because the closeness of the head to the piston makes it more likely that the mixture will be heated up even more. And the last one out here is the squish effect, and it's negative because these two are negative. And in case you're wondering if squish is so important, how come some engines get away without it? The process of ingesting the air and the fuel into the engine and the U-turns and twists and turns it has to take causes a natural amount of turbulence. And that is enough to get a decent output. But that's on low RPM engines, like typically 9,000 RPM and less. As you go higher than that, that turbulence is not enough to get a quick enough combustion burn to match the speed of the piston going down. And so that is enhanced by the small clearance, which causes the squish to cause a swirl, an extra turbulence in the head. The reason that some engines have the squish band, even though they rev less than 9,000, for instance, the 500cc dirt bikes, is because, not because they need that extra swirl, but because it lowers the piston temperature. When you have that combustion right here, and you've got, you know, 40% of that bore, you know, hiding away from that initial flame, it reduces the temperature of the piston, which is always good in a dirt bike or a race bike. So if you put a squish head on an engine that doesn't have a squish band, it will reduce the temperature of the piston. I did that to my Suzuki AX100, and it did help. It was getting overheating in the middle of the summer, which the summers there are like Death Valley, very, very hot. So now you have an extra insight on squish bands and the importance of that width of the band. It's just that all that volume of air fuel right here, you want it to swirl, okay? The larger that volume that's going to impact that volume here, the more likely you are to get a nice healthy swirl. You can get a swirl with a narrow squish band, but it's probably not as healthy a swirl as you would have with a more squish ratio. In which case, you'd want an even higher velocity, less clearance right here. Which, if you look at bikes that do have a narrow squish band, you'll find that that's probably, if they've been adjusted by a good tuner, that's probably what how they're set up right now, is for a very small clearance. But I don't like that because of the detonation risk. Yeah, squish bands, very helpful. Now you understand that a little bit better. And check out my other videos, like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.